Hi, I'm Charles.
And I'm Caroline. We got married in June and now we're sailing around the Atlantic Ocean for the year. Come join us as we document our journey.
In this episode, we continue to have some success with fishing. However, we do hilariously lose a couple of fish. We enjoy a lot more sunsets as a crew. We also find new ways to entertain ourselves. We have to go up the mast when our spinnaker shackle breaks, and we finally arrive successfully in St. Lucia.
Thanks.
Got him. Okay, Jules. Got another Mahi Mahi on the line. Kieran's just done a really good number on one. Let's see if I can bring this little schoolie in.
You need help, you good?
Good for a moment.
Got him?
Yeah, got him. Cheers,
take that. Six.
Pair of Mahi Mahi! Amazing! Well done, guys. Can we get the deck chargers going continuously? Liv, can you remove the, the handle.
Beautiful.
We then started to fillet the fish. Unfortunately, we didn't have a fish filleting knife, but we used the sharp global knives we had on board. It's the morning of the 10th day. Caroline's just on watch, watching a very nice sunrise. A very beautiful cloud just behind the ensign. Just trying to see him. There you go. The colours are amazing. I'm not sure if the GoPro is picking it up, but it's a very nice morning. Swell seems to have dropped a little bit, or the cross swell. The wind seems to have picked up a little bit. I estimate 14, 15 knots. We've got the genoa out and the main on the other side with a reef in it.
It's 10 days in and we've had our first time out. This is a self-inflicted time out from Mr. Dawson there. You may ask, what did he do? Well, he might have fallen into the cockpit and stuck his hand right to the middle of Liv's wrap. So that's nice, a little bit of extra smushing. Looking forward to eating that, Liv?
Yeah, you know,
we'll
help it go down easier.
Yummy.
So, dirty screen. There we go, much better. Ooh. Day 10, and we think that today is or marks the halfway passage or point of our Atlantic crossing. We have 10 to 12 knots behind us, so we've got the cruising chute up today. We have got the fishing rods up. We've caught a couple of amberjack, but we don't need any amberjack because we've got loads of mahi mahi from yesterday. Although I do have a big lure out, a very big one. We call him Boagrius. He's about 10 inches long with a huge hook. We're hoping to get a big tuna or a big something with that, and that would be amazing if we could. But all the other ones in the water are just to attract sort of fish to the boats, and hopefully Boagrius will get us a big tuna. You may have wondered what the logo on our cruising sheet is. It is the Centre for Regenerative Design and Collaboration, a company which Ciaran and I are part of. CRDC's product, called Resonate, is a breakthrough concrete additive made from mixed plastic waste, which we believe is the solution to the world's plastic waste problem. Resonate can take all types of plastic from any environment, including the ocean, and safely and permanently sequesters it into concrete building blocks. I will leave a link in the description if you would like to know more about this.
We are at the halfway mark, middle of the Atlantic, celebrating with some chocolate frozen banana smoothies. Yay!
Congratulations.
Well done, guys. Only half the Atlantic left to go.
So we've been on our cruising shoot for a good few hours this afternoon. And we are just inspecting our big boy lure, old Boagrius, to make sure he's got no weed on him. Which he does, doesn't he? So this is the big one. Look at that, Dawson's arm for scale. Hopefully this is gonna catch us boku big fish. Alright. End of day 11, is it day 11?
10.
10. End of day 10, we've got the cruising chute still up and we're about to have some din. The slow-mo pan across.
So close.
It's a really wide angle though. We're just all of us looking out for fish. We've got one, two, three, four lures in the water. Caught a few amberjack, but we're releasing them. It's catch and release only today.
Yes.
Tomorrow, once we've eaten a few more fillets, they'll be back on in open season.
Back on the menu.
Perfect. Cheeky bit of evening fishing.
Come here, fishy. Always a little good luck.
Yes, here we go. Come on.
Come on board.
Right
behind.
Already there.
Oh! Hello,
hello. Check this out on her amberjack. Shock, haven't seen one of these for a while.
No idea what it is. Hello.
Nice.
This was mine. Well done, Liv.
How are you doing, Liv, today?
Good, thank you.
It's been a good day. Not the longest distance travelled, only 119 miles, but we've had no more than 14 knots. Well, in fact, this afternoon we've had no more than 12, so we've had the cruising shoot out, and it's kept us at 5 knots, 5 and a half, sometimes 6, as opposed to motoring. So at least we've managed to keep sailing, and knocking off the miles slowly.
So we had a bit of a crash, and what happened is there's a block at the top of the spinnaker halyard, at the top of the mast, and that is attached to a D-ring, and that had come off. And so we've lowered the cruising chute, got ourselves goose winged, and luckily we have a video of Charles at the top of the mast where we can see what the setup is. But now to get him up the mast, we're having to bring down the main, to use the main halyard to get him up there. Ordinarily we'd use the spinnaker halyard, but clearly because we're fixing that, we can't do that.
What I reckon will happen is Boagrius will hook a tuna.
Yeah.
I'm at the top of the mast.
You okay? Just check the safety line, it's on the side of the spreader.
Yeah.
Yep.
At the top of the mast, middle of the Atlantic Ocean, fixing spinnaker block. The topping lift is about to break. Oh god, it's so rolly.
Keep going, keep going, keep going slowly, keep going. Yeah, he's on the mast. He's on the boom, sorry. Hold on, guys.
Nice.
How was that?
Fucking terrifying, actually.
Was it?
Yeah,
says. I'm on family. Yeah, it was fine, mate. It was really easy. Yeah, it's swinging around like a good 2-3 meters.
Jesus, it's really tight. So.
Oh, and the issue at the top?
The topping lift's about to fray. It's just the block, the pulley it comes up, it's off the side, so it's hitting the metal brackets and it's just rusting. It's over halfway.
Wow.
Just gone through, so can't do anything about it. The end of that. We need to nip it, so move it all up to 24 feet. That was, I don't even want to repeat that.
Very rowdy man.
Right, we fixed it, it was good.
To encourage the captain, crew and all. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go.
We were a little bored this morning and we played fives, where the loser had to dress up in full oilies and get a bucket of water thrown at him. Unfortunately for him, Ciaran lost this round.
We've seen there's a bit of rain coming on the horizon, so Dorsey's getting ready for it.
Raining!
We were then caught in a bit of a squall, so we quickly put down our rain cover. Later on that afternoon, we were joined by some dolphins. Later on, we caught a Mahi Mahi. However, it was catch and release, which is just as well, because this is what happened.
Yep. Ah. It's a wrap.
You got that, Liv?
Excellent.
The 1st of December. What? Here we go. Where is Wally?
How was your shift? Which one did you do? You did.
There he is.
I had
Thank
two.
You, Nicola, for the advent calendar. No way! You have to find the object, and this one is find the anchor.
Oh.
What are the chances?
Anyway, so this morning we found lots of flying fish on deck, put them in the tackle box, which is that bit of decking over there. We've also found one in the wash basin of the head.
Just a day in the life of a deckhand on yacht Caris. Deckhand 1 is doing her rig checks every morning. Has nothing to do with working out. This is how you become Deckhand 1. Quite rough today, as you can see. So she's got to check all the little nooks and crannies of the boat. Make sure nothing came loose overnight. We do this twice a day. What are you checking for?
Checking the mast. Check if there's any chins have slipped, whether there's any wear and tear. there's nothing catching, anything like that.
Looks good.
Looks good. We got some FF on board.
Oh! Uh-huh. Let's have a look.
Some little fishies.
Couple of flying fish. Are you just going to leave them on deck?
That's the tackle box. That's the bait box.
That's the bait box.
Okay.
Skipper, just leading the charge. First mate over there. The real box.
Look at us, drinking coffee while you guys do all the work. It's bad.
Life.
Life of the deckhand. So, if you don't know, my name's Ciaran, I'm deckhand 2. I'll be taking you through this day today and learning as I go how to become deckhand 1.
Play my radio for a morning song.
Oh, yes.
Another daily occurrence in the life of a deckhand is asking the captain what he thinks about the overnight forecast.
Overnight forecast. What, tonight or
last night's forecast?
Last night forecast. Windy, beam reach, 4 to 5. Swell, moderate. Visibility, good, occasionally poor.
We're expecting good things today.
Expecting good things. More wind, 18, dropping down to 17 knots from the east northeast.
It's an honour to serve under him. Another common issue that we have. At the moment, dish one is fixing. Tell us a little bit about it.
So, this is shows our speed and our wind speed, but it's solar powered, or the batteries sometimes switches off at night, so we have to make sure we reset it so that we can keep an eye on speed. There's DH2, just
stirring
his coffee.
This is a delicate task.
Don't trip up.
Do you want breakfast?
Love some breakfast, thank you.
Secret DHJ.
To get some cornflakes from the corner cupboard. Quite a demanding first mate this morning, actually. Oh! Cornflakes. Well, the first mate wants, the first mate gets. She is the boss of the deckhand.
Don't
worry. This is my secondary office. Coffee in the morning, absolutely key. Make sure the crew are caffeinated. Then make sure it cleans up. Keep it tidy. Breakfast.
Do you not get me one?
Making use of the buffet.
That was presumptuous.
My sincerest apologies.
Let's not just live with the China.
Is there any other one?
We will need another spoon.
About to make a strategic change. Stand by.
We're going to shake out a reef in the main. So, Olivia, could you open up all the clutches on the right hand side of the reefing line to carry the seine on the left hand side? And Ciaran, could you get the main and put it around the small winch, please? And I'm going to go forward and give you slacks.
We're shaking out the green as well, darling.
No, we're going to put the first reef in.
Okay, so green, poker green.
Captain heads up to the mast. He's going to do the halyard, which is kind of the fun job. I'll be filming. So Olivia has to free up the reefing lines, which hold the sail in place. You can see in the back of the sail and the front of the sail. She's just going to free those up and let them run, and then pull the blue line, which is the main halyard, and bring up the sail, give us some more power and some more stability. So the captain here is quite the fisherman. Part of the deckhand's job is checking his lines. weed. Lots of Sargasso weed in the Atlantic, often getting hooked up by our lines. Most people put out one, maybe two lines behind the boat. Captain Delaney has taken a slightly more aggressive approach. We usually have between four and six lines behind the boat, which results in tangles and lots of fish some weed. So part of it is checking on the rods. See the rods bouncing like that? Not great. Probably dragging some weed. Everything else looks good. Beautiful morning coming up to the Caribbean. Key part being deckhand one is the delicate balance between exertion and recuperation. So rest is absolutely crucial. Here is deckhand one personifying that perfectly. That's how you make the big bucks. Gotta fuel the troops. Tuna. Some dinner prep going. A little bit of marinade.
DH2 here, just checking the lines on the rods. There he is. Anything?
Nothing yet. Skipper likes a lot of lines out.
Cool.
We do what Skipper tells us.
Careful,
that bucket doesn't fall off.
That's amazing.
Nice. Well done,
Doors. Doors.
Doors.
English. Can I get the nice fish?
Dawson, what have you just caught?
What did you think it was? Albacore tuna?
I think it's an albacore. It could be a bonita. A bonita fish big.
Does it have the fin?
Yeah, it's not there.
There we go. Before dinner.
On the other side.
This is good side.
Look at that.
Thank you, fish.
That's an important part of
deckhand A.
Deckhands.
I've made a line down here to reach all this meat. Then we're going to go down the dorsal fin all the way back, both sides, and go down the spine. I just need to try and make the skin is super tough.
So it's the evening of day 16, 17. We're doing well. All's well on board. Hang on, we always have a mucky screen. Yes, so day 17. And we only have, well, we have less than 100 miles to go, which is excellent. Ciaran is cooking us up a storm. What's for dinner, Stores?
We're doing sushi rice and tuna, which we caught a week ago, so.
Delicious.
Ooh,
it's rolling.
I'm about to write the log for today. Liv, how far do you think we've gone?
I'm gonna go 155.
Ooh, that's good. Cara?
150.
Nice. Ciaran?
148.
156.
148.
Okay, let's get it done.
I'm going to go 158.
No, I think you're right.
Okay, so our distance run was 164.
What?
And that's a personal best, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. Our
that's
total.
683 knots.
Yeah.
Recurring.
recurring, of course. Our total distance so far for the trip is 2,183 nautical miles, and weirdly, we've closed 156 miles out of 164 to target. So actually, we closed 159 miles yesterday to target, so we're actually closed less proportionate. Yesterday, we were 162 and made good 159. Today, we're 164 and made good 156, so.
Wow.
Funny old world. Yeah, good.
More violent than I expected.
Thank you.
Ciaran has cooked
dinner.
Final
night.
Some delicious dinner as well.
Rocky!
Rock and roll.
This has to be the rockiest dinner.
Hard Rock Cafe.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Land ho!
Land ho!
Over there.
You won't be able to pick this up.
Barbados.
Barbados.
Is a shadow underneath the clouds. We're not actually stopping there, but you know, land ho anyway.
Land.
The final task of the day. Final task of the day before we settle into the night watches is the old rig checks. We've got DH1 and DH2. Checking out that rig. Of our night sail. How's it looking tonight?
It's all good. There's a pin that's been a little bit loose for a while, but we're just keeping an eye on it. No pressure at the moment, so yeah, we're all good.
Awesome. Good job, DH1. DH2 checking out the old fishing lines with the skipper. Another key part of their evening activities is reluctantly reeling in the lines.
Final sunrise.
So, it's the morning of the 2nd of December, the 18th day. In the distance, you can see St. Lucia. And over there, you probably can't make it out, is Martinique. So we have almost arrived at our destination. Crew are very happy. We've just gone goose wing. We had the third reef in the main and two reefs in the Genoa last night. We were broad reaching big swells and big seas, quite high winds and squalls. So it was quite a rough night. We've just gone goose wing now. We're cruising along around 6 to 7 knots, even with a very deeply reefed main. Now Olivia is going to show us the courtesy flag. So we've got the St. Lucia courtesy flag and the quarantine flag. So we're about to put that up on the above the mast. Sorry.
There she is.
Nice. You show us the ensign as well. Now we've also got a brand new ensign because ours, bless her, has done 5,000 odd miles and she's looking a bit raggedy, and we want to come into St. Lucia in good order, flying a very smart ensign. So we've got a brand new one as a treat for the boat. Look at that, very nice. So we'll go fit that as well.
2nd of December. Yikes, this is gonna be embarrassing. There, right there. Today we need to find the man in the tree. Oh, found him. That was quite easy.
Nice. Brand new ensign, nice and smart. Caris is looking very good now. Now we just need to put the courtesy flag up. So we're just coming into Rodney Bay. It's quite a narrow entrance. There's so much greenery around. Beautiful mountains.
is coming into Rodney Bay Marina. First mates.
10:50 boat time, which is 8:50 local time. We made it! Yeah! Yeah!
That's great. So, celebrating our safe arrival in St. Lucia. A couple of days after predicted due to the light winds, but we're all safe and we made it up on the last couple of days to meet ads on time. So, guys, thank you so much for making it such an amazing trip. For Caris and I, you guys will definitely welcome again.
Thank you very much.
Hey!
Nice!
You can't tell in the camera, but it's about 80 degrees, 80, 90.
Are you American?
No, Celsius. It's about 400 degrees.
Thank you, guys. We're having a final splishy splashy in the cockpit because it's about 400 to 500 degrees outside. Ads has absolutely won and brought us some beers for the boys and some ice creams, which we haven't had for a long time. So very, very happy. If not very hot boat.
Yep, can I get you a choc ice?
So, young Delaney.
Ooh, what is this?
As a little thank you to the skipper.
Oh, bro.
For everything that you've done and all your hard work.
Thank you so much. It's come with some fancy sauce as well. Yeah.
We really appreciate everything you did. And the amount of work that it took to get us across here.
Thank you very much. Cheers, guys.
You might recognize it, but.
Oh, it's this. Oh, what is this? I recognize this.
When planning and researching this trip, I picked up a copy of A World of My Own by Sir Robin Knox Johnson. Amazingly, when we were in Portsmouth, just before we set off, we were moored four berths down from him, where he was working on his legendary boat, Suhaili. It was amazing to see both man and boat in person, just after I had finished reading that epic account. Ciaran managed to reach out to him once we had left the UK, and he kindly signed the book, and the crew presented it to me here. It was such an amazing gesture. I am honoured to have such great friends.
He was very kind and gave us his address, and we sent the book. And Caroline and I organised a couple of little covert missions and got the book to him.
Some drop points,
and it took a few weeks. And
Bloody hell, that's insane.
Yeah, he was very kind. We just wanted you to have it for your journey around the world.
Oh man, that's honestly so special. I couldn't thank you enough. That's I was so hoping to try and get him to sign this when he was next to us in the Gosport. You only went and bloody done it yourself. God, I'm blown away. Thanks so much, guys.
In the next episode, we explore St. Lucia and enjoy arriving in the Caribbean. I do some fishing and we meet some friends.